Funding for Surviving Stroke comes from the Dr. Donald J. Goodman and Ruth Weber Goodman Philanthropic Fund of the Cleveland Foundation, the Margaret Clark Morgan Foundation, the McGregor Foundation, the Sisters of Charity Foundation of Cleveland, the Woodruff Foundation, the Community Foundation of Lorain County, and the United Black Fund of Greater Cleveland, Incorporated.
The most important thing with stroke management is time.
When stroke strikes, see what happens inside the human brain.
Well, this is an actual human brain from a deceased patient.
From surgery to clot busting, witness life-saving and life-changing treatment.
After my stroke, I couldn't talk.
He's continuously working on his recovery.
Now follow one family's experience, a story of surviving stroke.
Two years ago, the lives of Bill Forrester, his wife Lori, and children changed dramatically. The ordeal began with the family watching TV on a hot summer evening. Bill Forrester was not feeling well and went upstairs.
He decided to go to bed because he was not feeling well, his head hurt. My daughter Sierra wanted ice cream. I asked Bill if he wanted anything. He said he wanted sherbet.
While Lori ran to the store to get the ice cream, their daughter Sierra stayed behind.
Dad?
Suddenly,
Dad.
She heard her father fall down.
So I went upstairs and I went to open the door and I started freaking out because it wouldn't open. And I was like, Dad, are you okay? And he couldn't say anything to me. So I knew something had happened. So I didn't know what to do. So I called my brother because I trust him a lot and we're really close. And he doesn't live too far, and I know if anything happens, he'd always come.
I rushed home, and I got home within 10 minutes, and I went up to his bedroom door, and I had to push through it to push past him where he had fell. I reached down, I looked at him, took his pulse, and we realized that there's a really bad situation going on. So I immediately grabbed my phone, and I called 911.
Come home 15 minutes later, and my world has changed. There's an ambulance in the driveway, and it was 15 minutes and everything's different.
In that 15-minute time frame, Bill Forrester, at age 51, became one of the almost 800,000 Americans each year who suffer a stroke. Most people who survive a stroke suffer debilitating permanent damage. Bill Forrester is an exception. His story illustrates what's possible when things are working in your favor. In this program, we're going to follow his story. And using an actor to portray a stroke patient will also take you inside the hospital to see how the most common type of stroke is treated. Every 40 seconds, someone, somewhere, suffers a stroke, which is damage to the brain caused by the disruption of blood flow.
So the most common kind of stroke is an ischemic stroke, where the brain is deprived of blood flow, and it's pretty much like a heart attack is. We call it a brain attack.
Ischemic are blockage kind of strokes caused by blood clots. They account for about 85% of all strokes, and most stem from the same thing that causes most heart attacks. In a process known as hardening of the arteries or atherosclerosis, plaque buildup contributes to the formation of a clot that basically acts like a dam, blocking blood carrying needed oxygen.
The area of the brain that is typically supplied by that black blood vessel no longer gets nutrients and it dies.
The second category of stroke, which accounts for about 15% of cases, stems from bleeding. Blood vessels rupture and cut off blood flow to parts of the brain. Or sometimes balloon-like blisters called aneurysms form on the side of vessels and burst. To understand exactly what's happening during a stroke, we're going to examine both live and dead brains.
This is where we'll be making the incision.
These surgeons are shutting off the blood supply to an aneurysm to prevent a stroke. With the removal of this small piece of skull, we get a glimpse of a living brain beating inside the body.
This is a frontal lobe and this is a temporal lobe, and it's beating two times. It's beating once with every heartbeat, and it also, you can see it sort of expands up and out when you take a breath. So that's a normal beating of the brain.
Now neuropathologist Mark Cohen shows us what a brain looks like outside the body.
So this is an actual human brain from a deceased patient?
Correct.
And show me the anatomy of the brain.
Well, atop of the brain here, all this is, we call the cerebral hemispheres, and this is what most of us think of as our thinking and acting brain.
The average adult brain weighs about 3 to 4 pounds. Lots of veins and arteries run through it, acting as the irrigation system. Two main bloodlines, a carotid artery on each side of the front neck, help feed an intricate set of pipes on each side of the brain. If a pipe on the patient's right side of the brain gets blocked, it can cause left side paralysis, while a blockage in the left brain can affect movement on the right side. Dr. Cohen explains that pipes on the left also feed areas that control speech.
We have areas which control language, which are right up in here and right back here.
So your brain is like a computer. Every part of your brain is designed to do a specific function. When part of your brain doesn't get blood flow, that function is lost. So if it's the part of your brain that controls your motor control, you become paralyzed. If it's the part of your brain devoted to vision, you go blind. If it's the part of your brain that's devoted to language and speech, you can't talk. Hold this left arm up. Can you hold it up? You're in the hospital.
Just like heart attack, stroke is an emergency that requires immediate medical attention.
You need to recognize the symptoms immediately and call 911.
One easy way to remember the most common symptoms of stroke is with the acronym FAST.
F stands for face, somebody has facial droop. A stands for arm, somebody has arm weakness, actually, or leg weakness or numbness. S stands for speech. Somebody actually has difficulty speaking, slurred speech, or has difficulty understanding somebody else's speech. And T is time. Time is brain. 32,000 brain cells are lost every second during a stroke.
Bill Forrester had a blockage kind of stroke in a vessel on the left side of his brain. Besides hardening of the arteries, there are other less common causes of blockage strokes. And Forrester had one of them, a tear in the wall of his left carotid artery.
What you see as you come up is you begin to see all of this white area, and this is his stroke.
Forrester's survival and recovery depended on the latest and greatest medical science has to offer.